Yesterday, the governor of our state was being grilled in front of the Congress of the United States and the entire world because he willfully, knowingly allowed 89,000 households to drink poison water when he knowingly made sure General Motors did not have poison water to produce the parts for their cars. That's what we're up against. In the city of Detroit, 91,000 houses, families were shut off by water in the last year. Some of these folks have not had water for 2 years. This is what genocide looks like. This is ethnic cleansing. And the country has not looked at that until we have babies dying in Flint. Yes. So the country needs to know what's going on in Detroit. And all of this has happened because there is no democracy left in the city. We are under a dictatorship created by right-wing state legislators called emergency management.
There's a lot of other things that you want. That's going to end in a nutshell.
I was going to say a segue point between what you just shared and what I'd like to wanted to go more into around the water movement in particular, which is many of you have now heard about the mass poisoning that Shay just described happening in Flint. But what most people don't understand is that what's occurring in Flint is a direct symbiotic relationship with the mass water shutoffs that we've been facing in Detroit. And it's a direct result of the state legislature that appoints these top-down dictators called emergency managers to come in as mercenaries, as one of them has called themselves, come in and just completely work towards privatizing all public utilities, land, and anything, you know, making a place worth living in. And with the water, one of the main things that was happening when Flint got taken off Detroit's water was a move to destabilize Detroit's water system and therefore make it more vulnerable to be privatized. Mm-hmm. And so that story is not being told in the international spotlight on Flint, and it needs to be told because Detroit and Flint have been working in solidarity this whole time, even prior to the poisoning, has been working in solidarity with each other against emergency management and against mass water shutoffs. And Tawana can speak to this way more than me because she's been on the front lines of that very frequently.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Shay. Veolia Corporation, if you don't know the term Veolia Corporation, V-E-O-L-I-A, get to know them. I'm pretty sure that you could directly attribute them to the drought that's happening in California. You could attribute them to the privatization of water in Palestine. You could attribute them to the direct referrals or recommendations that were given to Flint, telling them that they could drink poison water. You could attribute them to the massive 3,000 to 5,000 people shutoffs in Detroit. You could attribute them to trying to attack the water in St. Louis, Baltimore, the privatization in New Orleans. So I could go on and on and on. And they're also directly linked to Nestle, Coca-Cola, anybody that's massively draining water from our watersheds, our infrastructures. This privatization of the water in Detroit and in the Great Lakes, we're on 20% of the world's fresh water right now. And so we're massively a target. And they're also pursuing a transportation system. There's this little choo-choo train that a lot of people talk about. It's the M1 rail. It's literally going to go 3.2 miles. So essentially, it's only going to go in gentrified areas. So it's really segregated transportation. And this is something that they've done all across the globe. I can rename all those places that I've already named. And so you'll see that Veolia will have contracts. You'll see that Veolia will have water and boycott, divestment, and sanctions. We need to be pulling our money out of these infrastructures. We need to not be purchasing bottled water. We need to be purchasing water bottles. And so, you know, there's some things that we're doing. Ill talks about this a lot, and Grace and Shay as well, is that the small-scale community efforts mean a lot. And so this is one of them, you know, owning this building, having these programs, bringing this information to each of you so that we can all be informed and we can do the organizing